The idea that you can swap out parts of the phone you don't like is an intriguing one. It's also one that has taken a lot of time without any obvious results. Lenovo's Vibe X2 may be the first taste of what it's like to live in a modular world. What do we mean? Let's find out. Lenovo's design ensues the modular aspirations of the phone. It's made up of different layers or stacks of colors that go on top of one another to create a unique design. The display is recessed and slightly smaller than the rest of the unibody, magnesium alloy chassis, and in keeping with stack theme, it creates an illusion of emerging out of the color layers. The bottom features a mini USB and the left a SIM tray which can hold a micro and nano SIM. The headphone jack on the top and the power and volume buttons on the right. If we have to nitpick, we could say that the volume rocker is slightly stiff, but on the whole the design is fantastic. A rarity among mid-range phones in the same price bracket. The Vibe X2 runs Android 4.4 with the Vibe UI 2.0 on top, and as with most OEM, Lenovo's has seen fit to have a lot of pre-installed apps on the phone. In its defense, some of these are useful, like the built-in security app, which acts as your anti-spam and anti-virus combo. It also has privacy and anti-theft options built in, but it is worth noting that you can't remove some of these apps. The software also has other tweaks like double tapping to wake the screen or double tapping the home button to take a quick snap even when the screen is off. The notification area is a different story, however, and with all the shortcuts taking up more than half the screen, it leaves the drawer looking a little bit cluttered. The multitasking pane also sees some enhancements like the option to free up RAM underneath or the ability to prevent an app from closing by swiping down on the app and locking it. In our experience though, swiping the app always closed it, so this only works to prevent accidental exiting. The long press of the home button brings up Google Now, and the left menu button acts as menu overflow or to bring up settings relevant to the app. A octa-core MediaTek processor with 2GB of RAM powers the device and holds up well for the most part. We did see consistent shutters and lags throughout the UI, nothing too major though. The back of the phone houses a tiny mono speaker, and while it's plenty loud, don't expect it to replace your headphones. There's 32GB onboard memory, which is pretty good, and the 5-inch 1080p display produces sharp image, but we did notice white light bleeding in from the capacitive buttons below, which was surprising. What doesn't hold up to scrutiny though is the camera, which produces rather average images. Some add-ons from Lenovo, a very different design, good battery life, and the instant photo taking ability may as well be enough to differentiate. But it's the layer and the phone's semi-modular nature comes into play. Using what are known as Vibe extensions, you can expand the functionality of the device in interesting ways. Two are going to be made available to start with. There is battery extension that snaps on and gives you extra juice in conjunction with 2300 mAh battery already on board. The other extension is a Bluetooth speaker that snaps on and acts as a stand too. This is a very big differentiator in this price point. When you look at other phones in the price bracket, Lenovo's design stands out and will make you sit up and take notice. The specs are also good, but specs alone don't make the phone. And Lenovo's unique extensions means that Lenovo could potentially bring more enhancement to the phone in the future. For Rs 20,000, the Vibe X2 does things differently enough to stand on its own and could well be your best bet under 20,000.